Welcome to our fifth episode of WISP Traveler. In this episode, we travel all the way to South Africa to bring you a story of Jumbo Technologies.
My name is Philip. I'm from a company called Jumbo Technologies. I'm one of the directors at Jumbo Technologies. We're a company situated in Gauteng area, Midrand. It's our head office. We also have another office in Pretoria, Montana area. We started off with just internet, wireless internet. We also do fiber internet. Yeah, we started about 4 years ago, started building the network, and then we started trading about 3 years ago. So we had a year of building up the network, and we're carrying on quite strong. We believe in excellent service, and that's why we also started looking at better equipment using RF elements as one of our main antennas that we use at most of our sites. Basically, when we started using just Ubiquiti equipment. I also learned to know the type of business and started doing a lot of research. I'm a big fan of trying to know about a lot of different type of equipment. I like testing it. It's one of the nicest things. I used to have Ubiquiti antennas, titanium, like I've mentioned earlier, and one of the antennas actually broke, and I had to change the antenna, but I just replaced it with a RF element sector panel antenna, 100 degrees, 20 dBs. To be quite honest, most of those links, signal strength went from -64 and -62, went down without realigning, went down to -54, -56. And the CCQ went up from 90s to 97%, 99%. In South Africa, the biggest problem for us is frequency. Available channels, there is none. It's a very noisy environment. So on your eyesight, you don't need any more noise from yourself. Already you've got enough noise from other service providers. Okay, so basically I started adding RF armor shields onto the Ubiquiti sectors to try and solve the radiation coming from the back of the antennas. It worked, but not as well. And then, of course, we always battled with that. And until Miro invited me to RF Elements to come and see their new product, where they actually built in the shield inside the antennas. And since I've been using that, we've really noticed a lot of changes in our noise level and also our CCQ levels. When we started replacing our current or old sectors, we started using the panel sectors of RF elements, the 100 degrees 20 dBs. Some areas it's horn sectors for areas where the tower or high site is close to the units or the houses, where we can tilt the antennas quite far down. And then also, if the space on the towers is limited, we also use the horn sectors. But we've got satisfaction out of both, out of your horn sectors and out of the panel sectors. The future of our company is to expand. We are expanding all the time. We just expanded to the Pretoria site, Pretoria East, West, North and South. We are also expanding to your remote areas. That's for us, that's one of our biggest challenges. And most of those areas, we're starting to use just the horn sectors. And the reason for that is your eyesight space that we are given, or that we can implement ourselves by erecting our own towers, is only 15 meter lattice towers. and there's not a lot of mounting space. It's not it can't carry a lot of antennas. So we will be moving into the future with mostly horn sectors. Yeah, to be quite honest, this is the first time that I can stand and say that equipment that was promised, it can do the following. I actually saw it with my own eyes. Did you already start again?
Yeah.
Oh, it's not paused.